This is the Pixotope editor. When you open up a project, this is the interface that you will be met with when using Pixotope. For those of you who've been working with the Unreal Engine before, you'll notice that it has a very similar layout as the Unreal Engine. Pixotope editor is built on the Unreal Engine, so every feature that the Unreal Engine supports will be accessible in Pixotope as well. Except for some custom Pixotope tools and a new color scheme, the Pixotope editor is very similar to the Unreal Engine. So let's have a look at what we have in our main interface. As you can see, we can start in the top left corner of our editor. You'll notice you have four different options in regards to what sort of production you are working in. You can choose between the internal VS, which means it's an internal virtual studio, like the one we have right here. There's the internal AR, which switches to an AR setup. The external VS and external AR are there to support virtual studios and augmented reality that are not created in Pixotope. Below that, we have two different panels. The modes panel is the same one as in the Unreal Engine, with the exception of our own Pixotope tab, where we've added custom tools that are steered towards broadcasting, productions, and pipelines. We have a list of different tools that we use quite often during our productions. We have the access to a virtual camera that we can pull into our scene. We have our internal compositing plane that will display whatever we are feeding into our engine. There's an AR reflected plane, and we also have some text mesh assets that will make it easier for live productions, whether they're virtual studios or augmented reality setups. These tools are explained in greater detail in the Pixotope Academy. Next to our modes panel, we also have our optimization panel, which is a custom-built tool that makes it easier for both artists and production managers, whether it's during testing or on-site broadcasting, to easily track whether it's frames per second or different sort of performance debugging overviews. In this panel, it's also possible to access our input feed as well as our output video. Below that is our content browser, which we can expand to display the source panel as well as our output log to view updates continuously in our level. On the right-hand side of our interface is our Pixotope Director connection window. As you can see, we currently have a data hub streaming into our Pixotope editor, but at the moment I don't have a camera tracker connected, so you can see we get a constant feed whether or not our tracker is connected and what the status of it is. We are also able to remove or bake any features that we add in our Pixotope Director into our Pixotope Editor. Any changes that we make in the Pixotope Editor will be possible to either remove or bake in to be a permanent change in our project. The World Outliner, as well as the Details panel, all display the settings that you would expect from the Unreal Engine. With our custom built tools, like our internal compositing plane, for instance, we have custom parameters built into that to make it easier to understand how and what's happening in our scene. Next to the details panel is the world settings. These are also accessible through the Unreal Engine, except for our own changes that we made that will make it more steered towards broadcasting and live productions. From here, we can access debugging tools for our compositing planes, as well as camera tracking, and we also have access to our virtual studio compositing and augmented reality compositing in our world settings. When creating a new level in Pixotope, the engine will automatically create tracked camera as well as a post-processing volume for you to access your most essential tools. With Pixotope Academy, we will guide you through all our custom tools and all our recommended setup for your live production.